Hi, welcome to Unique Designs. In this video, you will learn how to create vector sketch effect in Adobe Photoshop by using Photoshop Action. So let's start. Go to File and select your raw image. Note that image color should be RGB and bits per channel must be 8, so check them. Now go to Layers panel options and keep this last option selected. Another important setting is to keep graphics processor settings checked. For this, go to Edit, then in Preferences and select General. Select Performance option and keep this option selected. OpenCL option also must be checked in advanced settings. By doing this, oil paint effect in filter will be visible, otherwise it will be grayed out. So ensure all the settings first, otherwise this Photoshop action might not work for you. Now we will load brushes and patterns. I have given the link in description, so please download them from there. To load, go to Edit, then in Presets and select Preset Manager. First, keep brushes selected and load them. They have been loaded. Now, keep patterns option selected and load them as well. After brushes and patterns, we will load Photoshop action. Its download link is also given in description, so download it as well. Go to Window and select Actions. Click here at corner and select Load Actions. So our action has been loaded as well. Now we proceed further. Create a new layer and rename it by double clicking on it. Keep layer name as Area. Now keep image selected and select the character. You can use quick selection tool. Hold click and drag for selection. Now our character has been selected properly. Click on Area layer and select Brush tool. Keep its color to red. Now adjust size accordingly and keep hardness full. Apply this to whole selection. Now go to Action tab and select the loaded action. Click on this Play selection. It might take some time, so to save your time for now, I am just skipping it quickly. Now here you go. Our action has been applied successfully. However, it's not giving a good look. So we will adjust the settings that we got in the Layers tab. Remove this background elements layer. Also this splash and shadow layer. Now go to your object elements layer and hide these unnecessary layers. Note these layers. Now we are done with settings and it's looking perfect now. I want to change the background now for more cool look. Go to File and select Place Embedded and select your background as you want. I am placing that background here. Keep this layer on back to your character and adjust it. Now I'm going to apply some blur effect on background. Going to Filter and applying Gaussian Blur. You can resize your character. Select that object elements layer. Keep option as group here and you can resize it and can also adjust its position if you want. So we have done now. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you.